Today, we're exploring the exciting new fine-tuning experience for Google's advanced language models. These powerful models represent Google's latest achievements in artificial intelligence and are available through both consumer-facing tools and business platforms like Google Cloud, specifically through Vertex AI. The main idea is to take these advanced language models and customize them with our own data. The new streamlined way to do this is through the Vertex AI tuning page. Currently, there are different options available for the stable, generally available models from Google. These represent different levels of capability and cost. For our demonstration, we'll select the flash option and show you how to prepare your dataset for fine-tuning. To begin this process, we'll need an editor. While you can use any editor you prefer, we'll use the Cloud Shell IDE for this demonstration. Although we'll be working with an editor, it's worth noting that this process is almost a no-code approach to fine-tuning. We'll simply create our fine-tuning data using some straightforward Python scripts. This makes it surprisingly simple to customize a powerful AI model for your specific needs. In our data directory, we'll start by bringing in some example stories and summaries for our fine-tuning process. Our goal is to work with some lengthy stories and teach the language model to create summaries in our particular style. This is the essence of fine-tuning. We're teaching the model to produce summaries exactly the way we want them. We'll combine these stories and summaries into what's called a JSON lines file, often abbreviated as JSONL. The process is quite straightforward. We first read our stories and summaries, then create a list in memory that pairs them together. Next, we'll write this data to a training file using the line-delimited JSON format. We'll create prompts, remove any unnecessary white space, and write each new line to our file. It's important to use the JSON library here to ensure everything follows the correct JSONL format. To make everything work smoothly, we need to make sure there's a line break after each of our story summary pairs. While we could optimize this process by rearranging the code, we've kept the steps separate to make them easier to understand. When we run this process, we should end up with exactly 6 lines in our file, with each line representing a complete story summary pair. Thank you. Once we have our data prepared, we return to Vertex AI, where we'll give our model a name and select our base model. While there are advanced parameters available for fine-tuning, it's recommended to keep these at their default settings when starting out. An important note about these settings is that leaving them at default means you won't know the exact number of epochs or the number of passes through your data beforehand. This affects the final cost, since your total cost is calculated by multiplying the number of sample tokens by the number of epochs. The next step is to get our training data into Google Cloud Storage. This process is remarkably simple and requires just three basic commands: one to create a storage bucket, another to move our data into that directory, and a third to upload our training file. To verify everything worked correctly, we can check the Cloud Storage console to see our newly created bucket containing our training data. An important point about costs: using your fine-tuned model will cost the same as using the base model. You can verify the exact pricing by checking the Vertex AI Generative AI pricing page. The tuning costs themselves are also listed there, and there's a significant difference between model tiers. For example, it costs approximately 10 times more to fine-tune the Pro model compared to the Flash model. Because of this substantial cost difference, it's recommended to use the Flash model unless you have a specific reason to need the more powerful version. When we try to select our uploaded model from Cloud Storage, we might encounter a permissions error. This is a common issue with the straightforward solution. We need to go to the permission settings in our Cloud Storage bucket and grant access to the default Compute Engine service account. If you haven't used Compute Engine before, you might need to create a new service account. This service account needs two specific roles: the Vertex AI user role and the storage admin role. These roles give the necessary permissions for both storage and Vertex AI operations. If you're experiencing delays with the service account being recognized, there's an alternative approach. You can choose the Upload File option instead. This allows you to upload directly from your local machine after downloading the JSONL file, set your storage path, and proceed with the fine-tuning process. For those planning to use this in a production environment, it's worth noting that you might want to use infrastructure as code tools like Terraform to provision your buckets and handle data flow. From an MLOps perspective, you'll likely want to automate the process of generating your fine-tuned model. If you're using Terraform, you really only need Vertex AI and storage resources to get started. Features like object versioning and Google Cloud Storage can be particularly valuable for managing your training files effectively. Once the fine-tuning job begins running, we can click into the tuning job to monitor its progress and see additional details. After passing the initial dataset validation, we'll start to see important information about our training process. Let's talk about the costs and statistics in detail. Regarding pricing, the system charges about $8 per million tokens. In our example, we're working with less than 100,000 tokens, and each epoch, or complete pass through the data, costs approximately 1/20th of $8, or about 40 cents. The system automatically determines how many epochs are needed for optimal training. The distribution of our training data is quite interesting. We have 6 stories in total, and looking at their token counts reveals an important pattern. There's a significant difference in length between the input stories and their corresponding summaries. The summaries average about 260 tokens, while the original stories average around 10,000 tokens. This aligns perfectly with our goal of teaching the model to create concise summaries from lengthy source material. When we look at the model's capabilities, we can see that we're well within its limitations. The model can handle about 1 million input tokens and 8,000 output tokens, which is more than sufficient for our training data's requirements. After the training completes, we can check the Details tab to see the final statistics. In our case, the model went through 10 epochs, processing about 500,000 total billable tokens. This means the entire training job cost approximately $4. The exciting part comes next, testing our newly fine-tuned model. We can take a story and see how well it creates summaries in our desired style. Just like with the base model, we have various controls available for the generation process, including options for grounding, temperature, and output controls. When we run a test, we typically start with the system instructions followed by our story prompt. Even with an input of about 10,000 tokens, the model can process it and generate a summary according to our trained specifications. An important practical note is that this fine-tuned model isn't limited to just the Vertex AI Studio interface. You can access it through multiple methods, including Python SDKs and other programming languages. By clicking the Get Code button, you can see examples in various languages, including the direct API call using curl. This flexibility makes it easy to integrate the model into different types of applications and workflows. This standardized process works similarly across all base model variants, making it a reliable approach for customizing language models to meet specific needs. The process combines powerful AI capabilities with practical usability, allowing for efficient customization of large language models for specific use cases. If you'd like to support the channel, consider starting a free trial of our new design tool, which is linked in the description, and let us know what you think. We'll include the code and diagram file in the description as well. If you have any questions, please post them in the comment section and we'll do our best to respond. Thank you very much for watching to the end, and please enjoy responsibly.